Hello and welcome back. I want to talk today about how I quit smoking in 3 days by using technology of consciousness. And this is perfect example to demonstrate how technology can be applied to specific kind of situation. This applies to crisis management or any kind of behavior, fixing your behavior or that of others. And normally when you deal with something like this, you will have two approaches. Sometimes it's kind of like working from far. It's when what you're working with is not at the moment. For example, if you are dealing with something from the past, thinking of which makes you unhappy every time. So you think, okay, I want to deal with it so that I stop training every time I recollect about it. So you will be working and referencing back in time. But situations like crisis management or smoking, in this example, is going to be right now, here, right now. I want to have, for example, I have desire to smoke, so I'm dealing with it right now, right at this moment. And you do it until it stops. That's why it's good. You look at people or you experience something and you work on the spot. So how did I do it? To give a bit pre-story, I smoked while I was married for 8 years, heavy smoker. And I smoked little cigars, Captain Black, and I smoked the whole thing, inhaling. It's like cigar type of tobacco, so it was very damaging. Then I stopped at some point just because I thought I will stop. And somehow, I guess power of will already was there. I stopped, but then at some point I thought, okay, if I stopped, I can start again. Why not? So I did. And I smoked again, and that happened twice. Then I got divorced. I think even before that, I stopped smoking and never smoked until I went to Bali 2 years ago. And there I had some kind of events which were very upsetting, and I ended up meeting and becoming friend with a woman who was what's called a chain smoker. And pretty much instantly we got acquainted, and she was sitting with me at the table. We were having tea and she smoked, lit the cigarette, and I thought, oh, okay, I'll smoke too. And for 3 months, nonstop, like probably 2 packs for 2 of us. We just smoke, 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 smoke. And it's Indonesian cigarettes with bad filter, kind of not, it's very damaging. So at some point, and then I learned about technology, I learned that you can tweak consciousness with technology. And I thought, it's damaging for me. I'm smart enough to understand that it's not good for me. So let's see how to do it. So I kind of improvised. I wasn't even asking. This is the thing where you kind of understand how things work, instrument, and then you start improvising with it. So this is exactly how I did it. And I don't know. I know that it's possible. I know that people do it as well, but they tend to do it from afar. Remember I said at the beginning, versus I applied it at the moment like this. And 3 days it took, only because it took 3 days to find enough reasons, enough desires of mine for it to just disappear. The desire to smoke just disappeared, dissolved every time. So this is how I did it. Every time when I wanted to smoke, I would have cigarette right here. I mean, not cigarette, the pack right next to me with the lighter, and I would not lit. I would ask, why do I want to smoke? In your case, it's direct knowledge. Why do I want to smoke right now? And then, as usual, you will get some kind of either memory or thought or association with something, and then you start questioning, what does it mean if you don't understand? Sometimes you will understand right away, and as always, you figure out what filter is causing it. In my case specifically, I will give you an example. Like one time, it was three of us friends. My chain smoker friend, 40-something sexy lady in leopard shorts, and very young, he was probably 18 or 20-something kid, innocent, you know, like unlimited youth, just fountaining out of him. And we were at a restaurant, which was actually featured in movie Love, Pray, Eat, Pray, Love, something like this, which is a big place, but it was completely empty, middle of the evening. So we were at this significant place, three of us, no one. People, like staff disappeared, everyone. And they were playing some music, and the whole thing was for us. We were so happy that these two, they just got up and started dancing. And she was all sexy, you know? Very funny, hilarious. And he couldn't dance at all. Like the most hilarious thing ever, and it was so grotesque. And I, of course, I have something about the dancing still. It's just too complicated. I didn't look into that. It was not important enough yet up to this point. So I couldn't make myself to get up, and which means I was draining because I wanted to dance. Obviously, it's amazing. I'm super happy. I see these two dancing. It's hilarious how they were so bad. And I was thinking, holy moly, like this is, like, why? I see these two are dancing. They don't give anything. They don't give a penny about anything. And I'm sitting here. And of course, like I've reached for the cigarette, but then instantly I recollected and I thought, wait a second, aha, so I want to smoke right now. Why is it? I didn't allow myself to express my happiness. So I am draining because I am not allowing myself to be myself. And why don't I allow myself? Because I am afraid that I will look like this. So I'm thinking, I'm asking next, so what's bad about it? Why am I so afraid of it? What is in this fear of looking stupid like this? And why do I think it's stupid? And then I recollect, for example, I don't remember now, but I recollect how in childhood, in childhood, I went to the dancing studio for 2 weeks or so, and then they basically kicked me out because I was so bad. and then at the clubs, we danced with my friend, and I felt that I enjoyed it. Back then I actually danced, but I knew that I'm so bad and I look like an idiot, and it's, you know, I was 18 or 17, self-hate, self-destruction, like, not self-destruction, actually, I didn't have that, thanks goodness, in my life, but I have really low confidence. So all of that is the data stored in my mind and not letting me, this at that moment, see that nothing is wrong. They are dancing well, not well, it doesn't matter. The point is, it's desire to express your happiness, to make it publicly visible. Not to make it publicly visible, but not hiding it from anyone else who happens to be around. So I realized that, And I say heal all that, and direct knowledge that nothing is bad about expressing your desires. And then, and here I'm sitting, these two are dancing still, and I'm still sitting, hand on cigarettes, and I ask, okay, I healed all of this, and then I ask, do I still want to smoke? And then I feel, yes, I still want to smoke. So I think, I direct knowledge, what else? And then something else comes. For example, the same situation about the past, about the clubs, for example. And I think, what else is in there? I say it in the activation video that it's like leaves. It's a bunch of sick leaves. And I'm traversing this tree of my consciousness and coming to each branch and healing each leaf until the branch is healed enough, majority. It's not yellowish anymore, right? But it turned green. Cheesy analogy, but whatever. So as soon as it's kind of mostly green, the desire to smoke, the attention that that branch had sick leaves disappears. And therefore, and see, another detail is that not only it disappears, at some point, I mean, often when you will be dealing with it, sometimes desire, it's not that desire disappears, but you already, you know exactly, I want to smoke because of that thing, and I healed it, and I see that it's nothing wrong about it. So now I question myself, do I still want to smoke? Knowing that I want to smoke it because of this and that. Another example, with the same friend, my chain smoker, we're sitting, it was actually in the morning, we came for breakfast, and that was the moment when I had zero money, zero, not a cent. I didn't even have a wallet, nothing. And she, learned things together. And she, see, like I have zero, and she had issue with greediness. So we were perfectly matched by situation, so that we can, you know, both on each on our own sides, we could transform it. And she paid everywhere for me. And I mean, before that, she paid for her husband, for her friends, for everyone else in her life. And she was a businesswoman, and she's like, oh, I'm strong, I'm sexy, I put leopard shorts, you know, fun lady. But like, and yeah, if you are like this, there you go. You pay for everyone if you say you're strong. So like, it's your brain challenging you, right? I keep saying that. So, and here we are at some cafe, and you know, they brought us menu, and she is ordering something, and I'm ordering something too, and I'm sitting and reaching again. I'm taking a pack and putting it next to me, and I know that I want to smoke. Why do I want to smoke now? Not lighting cigarette. And then, of course, because I know and I feel guilty, and I feel ashamed that she is, here you go, she's paying for me again. And therefore, I want to smoke. See, what happens on the background with smoking, as example, is, I say somewhere that our soul, our body is, it's super smart, complex combination, right, of everything. And it knows that if it drains, then obviously it needs to gain it. So anything that drains, such as feeling ashamed that my friend is paying for me again, automatically I want to somehow get the energy back. But somewhere back in past, I got this connection that smoking is stylish, smoking is cool, smoking is sexy, smoking is blah, 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 whatever values my mind collected, attached. Neuron connections. Take this value, that value, and combine. And then it's actually mapping. When one fires, both sides, like brain doesn't have separate concepts. This is how BDSM, by the way, like pain and pleasure, it has it connected. So when one fires, another one automatically fires. So brain just doesn't understand difference, literally. And all of the, you know, bulimia, anorexia, brain have developed specific map and is using it. So as soon as you understand it, you start questioning, finding it, and just saying, yeah, heal it, separate it, so that I'm happy. So in case of cigarette, yes, like there, my brain is firing that if I'm draining my energy with the shame, then I automatically want to gain it, so I... because I already have this learned behavior, I call it. Therefore, I reach for cigarettes. See, I understand it. This is what happens on the background. I mean, with the hardware and software, our body. But like when you are using technology specifically to speed it all up, you ask, so why do I want to smoke right now, right? I got this shame. So first I can say right away, heal the shame. But after that, I can see that why do I feel the shame? If, you know, like if you get rid of the shame, judgment, being unsuccessful, like all of this will show up right away. But for me, I mean, I went deeper because I kept asking until it disappeared completely, right? So I came to the old memories in the cafeteria. My best friend, she always, she was from rich family, I was from poor, so, and she always had money, and she always, without even asking me, she would just buy something, you know, like she would buy for herself and she would buy some kind of pastry or something for me without even asking. So that, and then my another friend's grandma, every time I would come, we would do homework together, she would always basically force me to eat with my friend. Because I would say, no, 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 I feel uncomfortable, blah, blah. And she would say, no, you come and sit and eat. And both of those, and it's different times, both of them at some point, like months or years, wherever, they told, like, oh, how long can I do this, continue doing this? So see, person gives, gives, and then at some point, and you never ask. So my brain learned and reinforced through a second event that when someone pays for you, it's highly probable that person will at some point tell you something like this and that. So automatically, see, again, mapping. So if I get this answer, I understand it and heal it. And then another thing, I haven't mentioned it anyway yet, I think. Often you can, when you come up with a situation like this in specific, I was thinking, okay, in that case, how could I do it differently? Like when she told me, and of course, both of this friend and grandma, of course they told me, and that first time I probably was in shock, I don't remember even, but second time it was shame that, oh, aha, again, it's happening again, and they let it happen again, and you start beating yourself up and close and, you know, but how could I do it differently back then? And I am asking direct knowledge, how could I do it differently? And I get instant answer about which I haven't thought ever in my life. I could have just said, you know, that I've never asked. But it didn't even occur to me. So sometimes when you come up, ask, and that's the one of those find, when you work with desire and you find this tie, I don't want to have a relationship. I don't want to fall in love with a man or a woman because I'm afraid that I will lose my identity. Right? So how can I not lose my identity without removing possibility of falling in love? So you find the third option. Like, how can I do it differently? See? That's the logic. Another, like, third example I'll give. We were, again, with the same friend. We came to this club, and it was packed fully. It was so packed that they ended up putting us at the same table with some couple, another couple, who were from Australia. And my friend doesn't speak English at all. Like, zero. And she's standing there all grumpy and, you know, drained because she feels so out of her place. And even money don't help because she doesn't understand and no one is paying attention to her and whatever other reasons. And I'm standing there reaching for my pack of cigarettes. And then I'm asking why. Ah, and of course, and I'm happy because... like it's still a lot of energy and it's fun and we're at the club and I haven't been for ages, even though I still didn't dance. And it's finally English-speaking people because it was all Russian community. So I felt happy, but then I reached for cigarettes, see? That's the thing. And which means that I have drained somewhere on the background, even though I am overall happy. So I'm asking why. And then I understand, because we are at this table and we interact with this hallelujah English-speaking people, they said. And my friend tries to fit in and she asks questions and drags my attention constantly away because we are talking here. I try to translate back and forth because I feel, you know, like as a good friend, you have to make sure that your friend feels comfortable, you know, blah, 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 fix, 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 cut, cut, cut. So all of this drains me. But there I found reason. I asked again, asked, I healed it. Direct knowledge, how can I do differently, why, then I feel that, okay, feels like I don't want to smoke, or, as I said, do I want to smoke knowing that I want to smoke because of this, and I did it, 3 days it took me, why, every single time, why do I want to smoke now, and gone. No affirmations, no meditations, no beating myself up, no forcing myself or anything effortlessly. Why? Heal, direct knowledge, done. And that's how you solve anything. And I had episodes when I had 5 days of pain. I want to make a separate video of that. But pain, relationships, smoking, drinking, I stopped drinking. It was different kind of experience. I mean, I didn't drink as an alcoholic, but it's the same. You know, I love the tequila, like a shot before I go to some kind of, because I'm introvert. It's but for me, during marriage, I was so unhappy and miserable that it became a habit to have a bit of cognac. Every single day, I would be sipping, you know, like 50 or whatever grams of cognac. And because I felt so good about, you know, because that was little happiness. And that's why people reach for all of this, because it's, I think I talk about this somewhere. It's the way it interacts with our consciousness is exactly the same. It's just that one is unhealthy and temporarily because it wears off the effect. And this one is permanent, but it feels exactly the same. You know how you're super happy in altered mind. So there you go. That's how you do it. I hope it helps. Yeah, Anything is possible, seriously. That's why. Enjoy.